So again, we're going to make a probability distribution. One possibility is that we could win $2,000, and there's a 1 in 10,000 chance of getting that. Another possibility is we could win $500, and there's a 2 in 10,000 chance of getting that. Another possibility is we could win $200, and there's a 3 in 10,000 chance of getting that. Now, most likely, we won't win anything, and there are only 3, 4, 5, 6 winning tickets, so that means the rest of them are losing tickets, so there's 9,994 losing tickets, so there's a 9,994 out of 10,000 chance that you'll lose. So now our probabilities all add up to 1, and it's complete. So to get our expected value, it's just this times this, plus this times this, plus this times that, plus that times that. So you get your expected value, 2,000 times 1 over 10,000, plus 500 times 2 over 10,000, plus 200 times 3 over 10,000, sorry, and then we'll get that. So if I just do, all the bottoms are 10,000, so I'm basically going to add 2,000 plus 500 times 2 plus 200 times 3, and my top is going to be 3,600 divided by 10,000, and if I just divide that, 3,600 divided by 10,000, I'm going to get 0.36. So your expected winnings for this raffle is 36 cents. Now, we're done, it's okay, but this is a ridiculous problem. They even said like the raffle tickets were sold. And this is all assuming you didn't pay for your raffle ticket. Because most often you have to subtract, you have to put profits here. And most cases, it's not just that you don't win anything, you actually lose the cost of your ticket. So a more realistic problem would have some sort of cost for the raffle ticket. But this raffle is quite nice, and you have a positive expected value, which is not the case in most real-life raffles or real-life lotteries. So, yeah, there you go.